Hello, you lovely people. Happy Friday. This is Chris from Macombo, and I'm here with the Nokia 5 smartphone. It's one of three new Android phones launched by Nokia at NWC back at the start of 2017. It's €189 or £180 here in the UK, and it's basically your Moto G5 sort of competitor. We're going to take a look at it now, do a full unboxing, set up, and a virtual tour of the smartphone itself. So let's get stuck straight in, shall we? Enough jabbering. As I say, it's 180 quid here in the UK, so definitely a competitor for your likes of your Moto G5, your Lenovo P2, that sort of genre of smartphone, if you will. It should be good for your sort of everyday use, and hopefully it should have a decent bit of mileage on it. It's a Snapdragon 430. I'll go through all the specs and everything as well, so we know all about that. And here we go, here's our first glimpse of the Nokia 5. So we've got the grey model by the looks of it. It comes in a number of different hues: black, grey, dark blue, and a sort of a salmony pink kind of colour, not quite rose gold. But there you go. We'll take a look at that in full in a second. We just have a quick skim through the rest of the box to see if there's anything particularly exciting. I'm guessing not so much, but you never know your luck. Okay, so here we go. We've got a few little bits in this little box. The old connector cable. Hooray! It's not type C. Boo! USB 2.0 sucks. I'm assuming it's 2.0 anyway. You do get some headphones though. Hooray! So let's check these bad boys out. These look like they might be proper ear shredders. Let's have a little look. Yeah, it's the old plastic shell effort. So that'll probably make mincemeat out of your inner ear if you actually wear them for any length of time. But we'll give them a full test now anyway, just for shits and giggles and all that. And unfortunately, it's a European 2-pin plug. We often get this with review samples. They often come straight from Europe, and therefore we don't get the 3-pin UK offer. But hopefully, if you actually buy it in the UK, you will actually get the 3-pin efforts. That would be nice, wouldn't it? You're not to use an adapter or anything. Always handy. Some stuff hiding away under that bit as well. You get an undislag. Rude. Whatever that is. It's basically a variety of little sort of manuals by the looks of it in different languages. Prison man, I'm guessing that's French. Products, English, there you go. And etc. And of course, you get the Porky Pin device as well, so you can actually get into the thing and get your SIM card in there as well. So it's always nice to have. You don't have to fish out like an old earring or anything like that to get it all open. So that's the box, and there you go. Like the bit of the box art as well. It's a nice bit of camaraderie there. Nokia 5 bringing the world together. We can only hope, really, in these post-Brexit times. And on the back there, of course, you get a lovely little image of the phone, the navy blue version there, which I would have preferred, but never mind. I'm sure the silver will be lovely as well. And of course, just a quick rundown of the specs there, which we will do anyway, so we don't need to bother with any of that. So here we go, here is the Nokia 5. Let's just peel off all this shiny wrapperage and take a proper look at the handset itself. So it's actually got quite a nice design, considering it's a kind of a budgety model, I guess, pushing into that sort of mid-range pricing. It's got an aluminium finish, quite a smooth, sleek finish, as you can see there. Not much in the way of sort of lines or anything like that to break it up. All the banding is, of course, at the bottom edge and the top edge here, as you can see there. It's a one piece, it's a unibody, so that's a nice design. As you can see, small bit of Nokia branding on the back there. You get the single lens camera along with the two-tone LED flash. It's only ever so slightly jutting from the surface there, as you can see there, hopefully make out. Just ever so slightly jutting with this sort of metal rim. Very nice indeed, very slick. Down below, of course, you get the charging port, as well as the speaker grill as well. On this edge here, you get the SIM tray and also the micro SD memory card tray. So they are separate trays, and annoyingly, of course, they haven't been marked, so you don't know which is which. So you're just gonna have to guess, basically. Fun times there. You get the power and the volume rocker over on the other edge. And up top is, of course, the headphone jack. Lovely stuff. As you can see, it weighs quite a bit actually. I think it's 160 grams of the official specs. It definitely has a heft to it. You can feel that for sure. It's 5.2 inch, which means it's reasonably compact. So it actually feels pretty comfortable to clutch. It's got these nice smooth rounded edges, as you can see there. Fits quite nicely in the palm. Some serious weight to it, definitely, but nice all the same. You get more Nokia branding up top, so you're definitely not forgetting what brand of smartphone you are rocking here. And as you can see there as well, there's a front-facing camera. So it's actually it's a 13 megapixel rear camera, face detection autofocus, f2.0 aperture lens, can shoot up to full HD video. And at the front, it's an 8 megapixel, as you can probably make out from the rather wide lens there. It is wide angle as well, so you should be able to fit in all of your chums all in one shot, which is always good. As you can see below the screen, you get a fingerprint sensor built into the home button there, and you get physical back and recent apps. Buttons physically on there as well. So let's just see if we've got any power in there. Hopefully, yes. Bit of a vibration there. So there we go. As you can see, it's powered by Android. So this is one of Nokia's latest Android smartphones, the other was being the Nokia 3 and the Nokia 6. There's also heavy rumors of a new flagship on the way as well, the Nokia 8. So hopefully we'll have more on that soon. Let's get it all booted up. It's Android 7.1.1, so the latest version of Android that's freely available to the public, of course. I've missed that. I'm sure that'll bring back waves of nostalgia for our older viewers, such as myself. Okay, let's go! So Nokia says it's quite a pure version of Android that's in here. So they haven't bothered messing around, as in, you know, overlays or anything like that. So it should be a pretty straightforward set of process, and then quite a clean interface as well. So I'm just gonna get connected to Wi-Fi quickly. Oh, that's not good. not the best of starts. Let's hope that doesn't happen again. Checking info, ... Hopefully this won't take too long. Here we go. Right, so you can obviously sign into your Google account. We're going to skip all that for now, just for the sake of not making this video half an hour long. My name is not Joe Smith. Let's just not bother with that. And of course, setting up the fingerprint sensor. So as I say, it's built into this dinky little home button there. It's very narrow, so it's actually quite impressive feat making it in there. So let's just quickly add a fingerprint. Right, so here we go. We are ready to add the fingerprint. So as your typical Android fingerprint setup goes, just tap it against the surface a few times, nice and straightforward. Put your finger just to the edges. Yep, that's absolutely fine. It's nice and quick, and hopefully should prove pleasingly accurate as well. So it's always good to see a fingerprint sensor on a sub £200 smartphone. It's becoming increasingly common. So obviously the likes of the Moto G5 sported it. It's just a nice, I've already done my name, go away. Obviously it's just a quick alternative to the likes of pins and all the rest of it, which are feel a bit sort of clunky and outdated now, frankly. So yeah, definitely the wave of the future, except it'll all be about iris scanning soon, of course. So Nokia Experience Program, yeah, that's fine, whatever. And here we are into the Nokia 5's Android experience. So as I say, 7.1.1, so as we'll see if we just pull down the settings menu, this all looks nice and clean, nice sort of standard vanilla Android, which is always good. So as you can see there, 7.1.1, Nokia 5, fully up to date and everything. And hopefully, because it's a nice clean version of Android, that should hopefully mean that you get an update to Android O rather swiftly. So just like the Moto G series, shouldn't be much tinkering needed behind the scenes. Should be able to just power out the updates, and there you go, away you go. So it's a 5.2 inch 720p display, so sadly it's not full HD like the Moto G5, just full HD, it's a 1280 by 720 pixel resolution. As you can see there, let's just boost up the sleep time, because it's always annoying when it times out every 5 seconds. You got the usual adaptive brightness and all the rest of it, so you can fiddle around with that. Brightness level, you can boost all the way up. We've already had a play with this at MWC. As you can see, it's nice and bright on top brightness levels. So you shouldn't have any problem seeing that. Just get a bit of glare on the go there. As you can see, you can still clearly read all the text and all the rest of it. So that's definitely a strong maximum brightness. No worries there whatsoever. And I can't see a night mode, unfortunately. So it doesn't look like you've got the blue light filter, which is a bit of a shame. But you can mess around with the navigation key lights. You can get them lighting up when you like, and mess around with the duration and the rest, which is always good. If we dive back into the settings, as you can see here, it's just your usual stuff really. You do get a bit of NFC support as well, which is always good at this price tag. That's something that was missing on the G5, of course. So that's good to see. Notifications, you can mess around with all your apps. You've got full customization there. Battery, here we go. It's a 3000 milliamp battery and it's got quick charge 3.0 support as well. This is a Snapdragon chipset. And of course you get the usual battery saver mode and the rest of it as well. So that's good to have. You can see exactly what's been eating up your stuff. Memory, so I'll talk a little bit about performance now. It's a Snapdragon 430. So a reasonably punchy chipset. Definitely punches above its weight and all that. So it's found in a lot of budget phones. It's again found in the Moto G5, but seems to do the job. You know, you get the occasional little sort of pause as you're trying to start up an app or whatever. You'll be noticing that more in this unboxing video because of course it's a fresh phone. We're just getting it set up now. But you know, there's the occasional little stutter. It's not the swiftest of chipsets, but it definitely seems to do the job, certainly on the Moto G5, which again, like the Nokia 5, has a very sort of clean Android experience. So hopefully should do the job quite nicely just for your everyday tasks and all the rest, but web browsing, taking snaps, stuff like that, shouldn't be hanging around too much. That's always good. It's got 2 gigs of RAM, so not a generous amount of memory, but again, hopefully we'll do the job. Over time, you'll probably see a little bit of slowdown, but certainly should do the job for the majority of users, to be honest. In terms of storage, you get 16 gigs, I believe it is. Let's just find the storage thing here. Yep, 16 gigs of storage. As you can see, a hefty amount of it has been used up already just by the apps and the OS. 7.48 gigs used, which means we only have a quick bit of maths, about sort of 8 gigs spare to play with, which is a bit of a shame. But thankfully, it does have that support for micro SD memory cards, and you can plug in a card of up to 256 gigs in size. So that should provide plenty of space for all of your apps, games, media, and all the rest of it. So you can snap away as merrily as you like with the camera. Speaking of which, the camera, as I said before, it's a 13 megapixel rear camera, fist section autofocus, it's left 2.0, so hopefully should prove all right. Few low light shots, very loud shutter noise. Wow, hopefully you can turn that off because that's incredibly annoying. Let's just tap into the settings. So as you can see, you got a few little bits. You can add a spirit level, whoop-de-doo, grid if you so desire. Detection of scene, yes, you can have it on auto. Put a watermark display if you want. Shutter speed, shutter sound, let's turn that off. Hopefully that'll turn the annoying focus sound off as well. You can use the volume keys to take photos, of course. It's got full GPS and all the rest of it. So quite a simple bunch of settings there. So again, similar to the Moto G5 in that respect. And what have we got here? That's to swap between the 30 megapixel rear camera and the 8 megapixel front facing camera. You do have full automatic HDR if required as well for those high contrast scenes. Flash, you've got a two-tone LED flash. And of course, time and all the rest of it as well. And I'm guessing you tap this little bad boy, there you go. And you can swap between the different modes. There's very few in there. A beautify mode, not that we need that because we're all very, very good looking people, of course. Panorama, and your standard photo mode. So I'm not seeing any manual controls in there, unfortunately, unless I'm missing that somehow. Yes, we seem to have killed that awful focus sound, so that's good. Definitely a top tip there, kiddies. And of course, you can shoot up to full HD video as well, up to 30 frames per second. So no 4K support, as you'd probably expect at this kind of price point, but should do the job for your home movies, and hopefully we'll have a decent bit of digital stabilization to cut down on judder and the rest. We'll be doing a full camera review of this bad boy as well, and stay tuned for camera samples and all the rest of it as well. So yes, we'll be doing that very, very shortly. We've also got a full roundup of the best budget cameras that you can get right now, so check that out. So that, in a nutshell, is the Nokia 5. It's so far looking like a pretty decent G5 contender. So we'll be doing a full side-by-side comparison with the Moto G5, so check that out. That'll be going up probably about the same time as this unboxing. And if you've got any questions, comments, theories, just want to tell us how awesome we are, feel free to do that in the comments below. And thanks for watching, everyone. Love you, bye!